vista beneath, the vista within. I started writing this next poem on a train, but I didn't get very far. In fact, I didn't get anywhere at all. Suddenly, something happened to me and my brain completely froze. It wasn't even that I couldn't think of any words to write down. I couldn't think of any words to think. It was that much of a stopping. Maybe it was the heat, maybe it was the tiredness, but I had to stop. And so this poem is about perhaps how it might feel before something a little bit bigger that causes us to freeze like that. I stopped. There is nothing more. Even to blind oneself with the sun, enslave zero to close feeling, reach out to the four corners of the universe. No action, our attempts at imperialism. I stopped. Naught in all the earth sacrificed will restart my efforts. For I'm frozen, a fragment of a crystal of nigh infinite complexity, held by the one greater, the infinite. I had to claw each word from my transfixed mind. I stopped and stood before the one who is Yahweh, the infinite, and Deliquest. I'm going to need a volunteer for this next poem. This next poem imagines a conversation between St. Ignatius of Loyola and his apprentice, his mentee, St. Francis Xavier, and they're discussing what it means to be a holy soldier and this much bandied about and maligned term. So if anyone wants to volunteer to play the part of Francis Xavier, I'd be much obliged. Come on then, Peter. I didn't know he'd be here. I'm proud he's back.
Okay, which colour?
Yellow colour.
Yellow colour.
Pardon? Yeah, you can hold it, just speak in that one.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. Ignatius Francis Xavier. We fight a war. Are we not reconquistadors? Are we not mujahideen? There is war and the rumour of war, and we must prepare the insurgency.
A guerrilla war. For revolutions spin and lift the conglomerates to the top for a spell before they disintegrate, turning on each other. And though both the king and the republicans stand against us, we shall outlast them all.
My child, you are correct. For we echo Michael, just as the Dominicans echo Uriel, just as the Franciscans echo Raphael, just as the Benedictines echo Gabriel. And so we shout a war cry, who is like our God?
General, all of us have our place, our rank, if you will. But the holy soldier shall not be venerated. The very idea will be synonymous with that of a murderer. And then where is our position?
It is the same as before. It will be the same if the holy soldier is considered again praiseworthy. We fight the good fight, empowered, and we conquer with words and love, not blades and muskets. The world in nomen domini.
But what of extremists, General? We are thus, we cannot deny it. The very purpose of our foundation is zeal. What if one day zealous dogma overrides the desire for good?
On that day, Francis, our society will rise up, just as it did after every assault, and stand for the opening of the eyes of those, even those of the conclave, who have forgotten the consequence of fanaticism.